Let's talk about moments. Maybe you heard of it as torque. In simple terms, it's when we apply a force and try to turn it about an axis or a specific point. Imagine a wrench like this, and we apply a force right here. Now the moment created about the z-axis is the force we apply multiplied by the perpendicular distance. So if our force or the perpendicular distance is large, then the moment created about the z-axis is larger, and vice versa. If we apply our force straight along the handle, then you can see that no rotation would occur. Let me draw this line. This is called the line of action. Because the line of action of our force intersects the z-axis, it can't create a moment. Now let's say we apply a force at an angle like this. In this case, we can break this force into x and y components. So the only component that does work in this example would be the y component, since the x component line of action intersects the z-axis. When we apply a force, the moment vector can be found using the right-hand rule. So here, we're applying a force counterclockwise, so the moment vector is straight upwards along the z-axis. In two-dimensional problems, all we do is multiply the forces by their respective perpendicular distance to figure out the moment. The units of a moment magnitude is force times distance, so it's Newton meters. If we have multiple forces like this, we can find the resultant moment by figuring out each individual moment created and then adding it up. When I go through examples, this will become much clearer. Now, if we need to consider moments in three dimensions, then we need to use the cross product. We find the moment by taking the cross product between the force and a position vector. The position vector can be from the location where we're finding the moment about to anywhere along the line of action of the force. The force must be expressed in Cartesian form. That means you need to be able to do that, and if you're unsure or forgot, please check the description for forces along a line, where I explain how to do this step by step. You also need to know how to take the cross product. Again, there is also another video where I go through this step by step, so please take a look at those if you forgot. Now you will understand these concepts much better with examples, so let's get started. Let's take a look at a 2D moment problem. So we need to find the moment each of the three forces create about a point. The first step is to break each of these forces into x and y components. Let's start with force F1. Next, force F2. And lastly, we have force F3. Now remember, a moment is force times the perpendicular distance. You can see that the x components of both force F1 and F2 will do no work. That's because they both go through the line of action. So if we apply these horizontal forces, the bar won't spin about point A, which means we can get rid of them. Now let's take a look at the y component of force F1. The perpendicular distance from point A to the y component is 2 meters. So the moment is then the multiplication of the two. We also need to show which direction the bar would turn if the moment is applied. Imagine this bar is free to rotate about point A. If we apply the y component of the force, notice how it would turn clockwise. So that's our direction. Now we look at force F2. The perpendicular distance to the y component is 5 meters. The direction is the same since we see that it would spin clockwise. Now let's look at force F3. Now both components of force F3 will create a moment. If we look at just the x component, the perpendicular distance would be 4 meters. If we look at the y component, the perpendicular distance is 5 meters. Now we need to be careful. The x component would cause the bar to turn counterclockwise, while the y component would cause the bar to turn clockwise. So assuming clockwise to be positive, the moment created by the x component will be negative, while the moment created by the y component will be positive. Since our answer is positive, and we assume clockwise to be positive, then force F3 would create a clockwise moment about point A. Those are answers. Let's take a look at this problem, where we need to find the moment created about point A, and we also need to find another force applied at point C to create the same moment. So first, we will break the 70 Newton force into its x and y components. Now let's assume clockwise to be positive. So the moment at A can be written as the force times the perpendicular distance. So for the x component, the perpendicular distance is 0.9 meters, and for the y component, it's 0.7 meters. The next part of our question asks us to find another force that would create the same moment. If we apply a horizontal force at point C, we can create a moment about point A. The perpendicular distance would be 0.9 meters. Let's solve for the force. So this tells us that if we apply an 82.1 newton force at point C horizontally, it will create the same moment about point A. Let's take a look at a problem involving moments in the x, y, and z plane. We have a bent rod with a force applied at the end, and we need to figure out the moment created about point O. So to find the moment about point O, we need to use this equation. So we will take the cross product between the force and a position vector from point O to C. So that means first, we have to express the force given in Cartesian form. Before we do that, let's write down the locations of all the points of interest. Now, let's write our position vector from A to C. The next step is to find the magnitude of this position vector. Using the magnitude, we can find the unit vector. So finally, to express our force in Cartesian form, we multiply the magnitude of the force by the unit vector. Next, for our equation, we need a position vector from point O to C, which is where the force ends. Now we can take the cross product. That is our answer. Let's take a look at this problem, where we need to find the moment created about point B when a force is applied at point C. Since the force is already given to us in Cartesian form, we can set it aside. The only thing we need is a position vector from B to C. So let's write down the locations of points B and C. Now we need a position vector. Now we just take the cross product between the position vector and the force. And that's our answer. Let's take a look at one last example where we have to calculate the resultant moment created by two forces affecting the flagpole. First step is to express both forces in Cartesian form. I'm going to do this quickly. So we need two position vectors, one from A to C and another one from A to B. Next, we calculate the magnitude of each position vector. Now a unit vector for each cable. Lastly, we multiply the magnitude of the force by the unit vector and we get our forces in Cartesian form. Now we need two position vectors. I'm going to pick the two vectors from O to B and O to C, though you can pick a position vector from O to A as well. You will still get the same answer since the position vector can be from point O to any location on the line of action of force A. Now we take the cross product for each force. Since we're looking for the resultant force, all we need to do is add these values together. So remember, when we add, all we do is add the I components to I components, J components to J components, and K components to K components. That is our answer. If you did a position vector from O to A, it'll be simpler since you don't need two position vectors. But I wanted to show you actually can just take the moment from O to where the force is ending, which were points B and C. That should cover the types of problems you will face with finding moments. I hope this video helped, and thanks for watching. Best of luck with your studies.